High Watch Farm has always meant a great deal to me. It's given me a lot more than I've ever given it. And I haven't been nearly as close to it in recent years as I would wish. Many of you have heard my story, and I'm not going into all of it. But suffice it to say that at the end of 5 years of hell on earth, I had finally found a doctor who was willing to take me under his wing. I'd been completely honest about my drinking with all the doctors. This was in 1937, and I never once heard the word alcoholism mentioned by anybody. I didn't know the word myself. I knew I drank too much. And Dr. Tebow came into New York once a week to interview people who were thinking of coming to Blythewood and whose families wanted to put someone in Blythewood. Dr. Tebow came into New York. He had been reading this manuscript, and he thought maybe this was something that would help me. And he handed it to me, and the title of it was Alcoholics Anonymous. Many of you have heard me tell of what happened to me with that book. It has a relation to the farm and to its meaning for me and for many others. When I started reading the book, I was thrilled to death because here for the first time I found out what was wrong and that this was a program to deal with the obsession of the mind that drove you to drink against your own will very often when you didn't want to. At last, I could understand why it was that I couldn't go back to drinking the way I used to. Something had changed, and I would never be able to take alcohol normally, and I accepted it. Dr. Tebow wanted me to remain on at Blythewood, and so I stayed almost 6 months. And finally, in mid-September, I was due to go. This was 1939. I had attended my first meeting on April 13th. 2 days before I left, the ambulance had screamed up and a stretcher had been carried out, and there was a girl in a straitjacket on the stretcher. It was Nona Wyman, and she had been brought back. Nona, of course, was an alcoholic. She was terribly drunk. She was suicidal. It wasn't possible, really, to talk to her. Of course, I had the book with me, and I started reading it out loud to her. She was receptive. She was willing to listen. She and her husband both drank too much. But they had a friend who had suggested some 3 or 4 years before that they go up to a place in Connecticut where this friend thought they might find some help. And they had started going up to this farm near Kent, which was run by a very strange little old lady who called herself Sister Frances. She said, "You know, I believe that this AA that you're telling me about is exactly what she's trying to do. I think she'd be very excited about this." The interesting thing was that I never wanted a drink while I was up there. I never drank while I was at the farm. But I wouldn't be home very long before I'd start again. She said, "It does something strange to you. I don't know what it is. It's wonderful." A few weeks later, the two of them succeeded in getting some of us to agree to go up and see this remarkable place. It was a beautiful weekend in October, and we drove up. There was Bill and Lois and Horace Crystal and Bert Taylor and myself with the Wymans. All of you know what it's like as you come over the hill or come up to the top of the hill and suddenly there's that adorable little house with just a smallish barn across from it in those days. We stepped over the threshold and Bill turned to me and he said, "My God," he said, "you could cut it with a knife." And I said, "Yes, you could." The atmosphere, the feeling. There was something there, something that was really palpable that you could feel. And every one of us felt it. That was one of the most wonderful weekends I have ever spent. We talked far into the night with this extraordinary woman called Sister Frances, who was a very lovely person. And the reason she called herself Sister Frances was because St. Francis of Assisi was her favorite saint. Her real name was Ethelred Folsom. I'm not surprised she took Francis. And what is at the farm was already at the farm before we ever found it. It found us, in my opinion. The story of that farm, as I had it from Sister Frances, is pretty fascinating. She set out looking for a place, and apparently she searched for a long while until one day she found this. It's really a cup in the hills, and this was the place for people who were in trouble of any kind, whether it was physical trouble or mental trouble or spiritual trouble, material trouble. They could try to find themselves, and if they did, they would go away refreshed and able once again to cope with life. The farm was known all over the world, and people came there. But the thing that really happened to Sister Frances when she met AA was that she fell in love with AA. We all made use of the little chapel. We all went in there for our quiet time. And before the end of the weekend, she'd offered it to us, lock, stock, and barrel. She said, take it. She said, we're incorporated as a nonprofit corporation, the Ministry of the High Watch. That's where that name came from. And we began making use of the farm. And when I say making use of it, what I mean is that we would take somebody up there for a week or 2 weeks, usually stay with them. I went up there so frequently, I was working like a beaver to get some women into AA. There isn't any question that there was something healing just about being there. I know what the farm means to someone who needs it, because I needed it, and I found there what I needed. Little by little, people became more interested in it, particularly as people came away from there and stayed sober. Little by little, it was transformed into truly an AA place. I know of no one who was happier at the way that gift was being used than Sister Frances herself. I have visited a great many places that have indeed sprung up in its image, but I have never been anywhere in the world that has the thing I'm talking about that exists at the farm. There is something in the air. God has his finger on it. Thank God.